Welcome to the ti-rtos workshop. My name is Eric Wilbur, and this is...
And I'm Scott Specker.
And we'll be your instructors for this online workshop on ti-rtos. So Scott, what are the goals, the overall goals for this workshop?
Well, basically, we want to get you up and running with ti-rtos, figuring out how to use it in your systems and your embedded applications.
So a lot of times, you know, besides taking a workshop online, the other alternative is, hey, look up all the user guides, getting started guides, evaluation module, user
guides,
and so forth.
Sounds like weeks of reading.
Weeks and weeks. And what we've heard is 4 to 6 weeks, you can get to the same spot as we're going to take you over the next 10 to 12 hours.
So we're going to start off talking a little bit about not using the RTOS. What is it like when you just build a regular old embedded system? So even if you're not an expert, we're going to get you kind of up and running right away. And then we're going to start feeding in parts of ti-rtos, learning how to build and create systems kind of piece by piece.
One piece at a time. So what's the overall look and feel that people can expect of this workshop? How do we go about teaching these concepts?
So in this workshop, we really have we're going to have a video discussion. So we're going to kind of do some video, look at different topics, kind of explain them, give you some background, and then we're going to turn you loose on some hands-on lab exercise. So you're going to be able to work through a set of problems and build solutions, again, one by one, building up as we go along.
So this is chapter zero, right?
Yeah,
life and software engineering starts with zero, not one.
Ordinal zero. Yeah.
So what are they going to do in the lab for chapter zero, Scott?
Yeah, we haven't even installed the tools yet. We're going to do that in the next chapter. In this one, we're going to actually do what we call the out-of-box experience.
OOB.
OOB, the OOB. So what we're actually going to do is use each one of your boards comes with a built-in application, a little sample application.
Most of them do.
Most of them do. And
yeah.
So we're going to play around with that in this lab. And in the next lab, we're going to go ahead and start installing
the tools.
Right.
Okay.
So
sounds
I guess we
good.
Better get going. Here, let me grab. And there we go. Let's go.
What? Holy cow, Scott. I mean, you just pushed me out of the way.
Hey, we need to get started.
Getting started. Well, that's the title of the workshop, Getting Started with ti-rtos. Are you ready to get started?
I am.
Okay, well, one thing I wanted to note before we get started is the name of our company, Embedded Advantage. We're going to tell you a little bit more about that in a few slides. But this whole idea of in association with, what does that mean?
So we're working with Texas Instruments on creating material for their processors.
Yeah, and they are actually involved in helping spec out what topics we should cover based upon their customer interests, EDE forums, what are the most common questions. So we work closely with them to architect the outline and how we go about labs and so forth.
Great. Well, it's nice to be working with those folks. And as we've mentioned before, we're actually XTI employees. And so we're working with old friends.
Yep. Let's get started. All right, Scott. So welcome to the workshop introduction. Okay, Scott, so here we are at chapter zero, right? Life with embedded software engineering always starts
with zero.
Got to start counting from zero. So what are we going to do in this chapter? The first thing we're going to do is just talk about what the students, what you as the listener, person watching this video, taking this workshop, can expect in terms of your user experience. You know, the value proposition of why did we choose these topics? Why did we choose this agenda? Also, we're going to talk about the benefits of Embedded Advantage workshops. Where does our experience come from? What kind of gives us the credibility to create these workshops for the embedded software engineers out there. So the next thing we'll cover is the overall agenda of the ti-rtos workshop. So what topics are we covering and in what order? Basically, the first four chapters are going to be related to traditional embedded programming, so non-rtos related. And then from chapters 5 through 12, we're going to start looking at the ti-rtos building blocks. Then we'll take a look at the overall workshop datasheet. What's inside the datasheet? It's what co-composer version does our workshop currently support? What targets, what SDK versions, software versions, etc. So you can get a feel for and download a PDF version of this to see what's supported in the workshop to see if it matches your specific target and application. And then we're going to compare and contrast different ways to do the labs. So Scott, at the end of this chapter, there's really not much we've taught them. So what kind of lab are we going to do at the end of chapter zero?
Looks like we're doing an out-of-box lab.
And that makes sense because you've gotten a launch pad or you're going to be purchasing some sort of target board. What's on that target board? What software comes with it? What's the out-of-box experience look like? Just getting used to what's on the board and familiarizing yourself with the contents and so forth.
It's a great way to get started before we actually install all the software tools in the next chapter.
Okay, makes sense. So Scott, here's the agenda for this chapter, chapter zero. First thing we're going to talk about is just give you all a short introduction to who is Embedded Advantage, what is our background, sort of our credibility statement, things we've done in the past. Then we're going to talk about what are you in for in terms of the agenda for the entire ti-rtos workshop. Then we'll go through workshop logistics. That was that workshop data sheet you talked about earlier. It's what revs of the boards and software development kits that we currently support for this workshop. Next part is, how do you do the labs? What are different options for that? You can either go really fast or slow. It all depends on, you know, the, you get out of it, the more you put into it. So it's really a matter of how much time do you have. And then we'll send you off to Lab Zero, which is the out-of-box demo.